Hello, Gunner James 105. Got a rifle here that I bought about 38 years ago at a gun auction. Went with my uncle. My uncle is about a month and a half older than I am, believe it or not. And we didn't have a lot to spend. I don't recall whether he bought anything, but I went home with this here, which I think it was around $100, $110 I ended up paying for it. I was looking for an old military rifle. I was looking for an old number one Mark III. And so this one here, which was about the cheapest thing at the sale, there were other number one Mark IIIs that went for more money, more than I could spend. So I brought this home, and I was a little disappointed because I wanted a British or Canadian, maybe even Australian World War I rifle. And turns out that this is none of those. This one here turns out through research years later when Google came about and one could type in information and so I discovered that this is a one of only 10,000 that were made. This is one that was commissioned by the King of Siam back in 1919. I think they took delivery in 1920. But so the rifle, I guess the thing that confused me was the normal spot that would have your year and you'd have an emblem and all that sort of thing would be there. Well, this doesn't have that, and it has some sort of script that I didn't know what it was. Years later, a year or two ago, I was able to find a site that translated this. And so what this is a Wild Tiger Corps Enfield. And so, yeah, 10,000 were made. That's it. And I actually took it out to the range. It's the second time since I've owned it that I've shot it. The first time I was a little concerned about whether I might have a problem or not. I've never had the head space checked. And so I took it out to the range in it, and it worked fine. Took it out today and have some video to follow shooting this at the range, but the thing worked fine. The bore is real good. All the workings are real good. There's no problem that I can see, and matter of fact, even the groupings were pretty good. So this here I'm going to give some close-ups on just to show a lot of the markings. The information that's out there is scarce. I had some years ago when I first started checking this out, I had rounded up and printed off quite a bit of information, which I can't seem to find. But I can tell you that the king that had commissioned these, now I had to write this down because there's no way I'm going to be able to pronounce that, but that is his name. And so he was also known as Rama the Sixth. And on here in this Siamese script, Siam, which is now Thailand, it has it's Ram the Sixth, model 2462, which means 2462 is 1919 in the Siamese calendar, and then it has Wild Tiger Corps, and there's a little tiger head here, and there's also on the back of the bolt, and on the let's see, it's on here on the side here. The numbers aren't matching on this one. The habit was that I guess when they were done for the day, they'd throw them all into a basket and lock up the rifles and grab a bolt for the next time they used it. So not a lot of these are going to have a matching bolt. If you have one, then you'd be pretty lucky. They actually had a bayonet with the Wild Tiger Corps symbol on it as well. When I bought this, it came with a bayonet, the correct type of bayonet, but not the Wild Tiger Corps. Those, last I checked, maybe 2 years ago, I saw one on eBay for a starting bid of $300. They're quite rare. So they would have used this type here. This one here, I believe, not a lot of markings on it, but the markings that are there, I believe this is an Australian 1907 pattern. Pretty impressive when one snaps that into place. So you've got a fair sized or fair distance between you and the enemy. It was Birmingham Small Arms B.S.A. that got the contract for this, and so they had done these. Now, the dark wood that you see was the other thing that kind of was a question mark that I had for a long time. And the dark wood is from the jungle climate, so that's what caused this to get real dark like this. And a lot of these, who can say how many are left, because they a lot of them rotted away in the jungle. I know that the Japanese invaded at one point and destroyed a bunch of these. So in the world of firearms, military firearms, 10,000 to begin with is a pretty small number. And this approaching 100 years old, I have seen them surprisingly from time to time at gun shows, but I don't know if more came to Canada and Australia than elsewhere. I'm not sure. Maybe some ended up in England, but the rifle is turns out very unique and worth a lot more than what I had thought initially. I don't know if anybody else that was at the auction knew anything about these when they were bidding on them. Or this one, I should say, it was the only one there like this. So I'm gonna lay it down on a table and get some close-ups on the markings. So just hang on. So I have lifted the bolt up so you can see this ring, and just gonna try and get first off a good picture of that. Get the light right and the focus is okay. But yeah, this is basically what we're looking at. So up top, I believe, is translated Wild Tiger Corps, and then here is Rama the Sixth with that year there. And on the while we're over here on the bolt, you can see a serial number, but you can't read that serial number because it's in Siamese script. But the British decided, BSA decided, that they would put a serial number there in numbers that we would recognize on the bottom part of the bolt. So then just turning it over, the BSA company stamp there on the opposite side, and then there are traditional BSA marks with the stacked rifles there, and then there would be the Siamese. Should have this showed you this one on the wrong side.
to begin with. But anyways, there's the serial number of the rifle in Siamese script. So, as I say, the wood is very dark on this. The rifle is in real good condition. There's nothing wrong with any of the workings of this rifle. It works pretty well. Everything functions the way it should. And so going down the rifle, everything's pretty much a number one Mark III. The slings usually didn't survive. They of course rotted away, and you can see there's quite a bit of slop and wear in this band here. But other than that, the rest of the rifle is pretty good. And all I've done, I've cleaned it very well, best I could. I've never really taken it apart, but cleaned it up and did the wood in a, I think, yes, that magazine also, that's been replaced. That's not an original magazine, which is about the only thing not original on this rifle. So you've got your standard brass buttstock, or butt plate, sorry. And so I'll just back up and give you that view. Might as well be in a broom closet here, that's how small a space I'm in right now. But anyways, this is the rifle overall. Quite happy to have it, and quite happy to share the information that I have on it, because there isn't a lot of information on it out there. Not a lot of videos on it. So let's flip her over and give a, you can see it's a little rough in spots, but otherwise, pretty much all complete. So, I don't know if I mentioned, but this King of Siam had attended Sandhurst and, of course, used this a lot when he was there, Sandhurst Military College. And that's where he got the idea that he needed to have this for his Wild Tiger Corps, which was a like a militia, personal bodyguard and militia unit. So, a little piece of information I forgot to mention. And so, give you a little bit of the video I shot at the range today.